Hi, I am Andy. I'm one of the teachers at the Harvard Museums of Science and Culture, and we are going to do a craft together. I'm going to show you how you can make a paper model of a giant stone monument called a stela. This is what it'll look like when you're finished. All you need to do is download and print this sheet of paper right here. This monument is called the Victory Stela of King Esarhaddon, and we can see him here looking like a giant compared to these two defeated enemies. The actual monument is huge. It's like 15 feet tall. He was the king of ancient Assyria, which today is in the Middle East. And here, he's making some offerings to a bunch of gods represented by all these symbols. I made a colorized one so they're easier for you to see. See this yellow one right here? That's the sun god, Shamash. We can see a sun disk with wings. And we also included a key to the god so you can figure out who everybody is. There are 12 in total. We have this in both English and in Spanish. And just for fun, I made a fully colorized one too. You can do the same thing if you want. You can see it looks a lot better. Just make sure you color it before you start folding it up. And before I show you a couple more quick tips and tricks on the best way to cut and fold this up, we're gonna go into the museum and hear a little bit more about this amazing object from the experts. But first, really quickly, before you see our version of the monument in the Harvard Museum of the Ancient Near East, I want to show you on the globe where this monument was originally located. It was found here in what's now modern day Turkey. And it was brought to a museum in Berlin, Germany, discovered by archaeologists a long time ago. And our copy that you are going to see, it's on the third floor of the Harvard Museum of the Ancient Near East, here on the campus of Harvard University in Cambridge, Mass. And here we are.
You are looking at the largest object in the museum's collection. It's a monument called the Victory Stele of Esarhaddon. You can see Esarhaddon standing about 15 feet tall. Listen to how he introduces himself. The great king, the mighty king, king of the universe, king of Assyria. That's just one little part of the long inscription on this magnificent monument. Esarhaddon wants you to be impressed with him and afraid. This is actually a copy of the original that the museum purchased over 125 years ago. This painted plaster replica was made only about 4 years after the ancient original was discovered in Turkey by a team of German archaeologists. The original monument is almost 3,000 years old and is now in a museum in Berlin. King Esarhaddon ruled the huge empire of Assyria in the 7th century BCE, almost 3,000 years ago. He made his empire bigger by conquering nearby enemy cities. He's the largest person on the monument, and he shows himself holding an offering cup up to the gods. 12 different gods are represented by those symbols up there on the top right. At his feet are two of his conquered enemies, begging for their lives. The smaller one kneeling close to him is an Egyptian pharaoh, or prince, and the other one is the king of Sidon. That's a different city. Coming out of their noses, you can see a leash that the king is holding. On the right side of the monument, you can see Esarhaddon's oldest son. His name is Ashurbanipal. He became the ruler of Assyria when his father died. On the left side is another of Esarhaddon's sons. His name is Shamash Shumukin. He got to rule the territory of Babylon. The two brothers did not like sharing power. They eventually fought a war. The older brother, Ashurbanipal, shown on the right, was the winner. and he became the sole leader of the entire Assyrian Empire. Scholars think that this monument was about showing off the complete and total power of the Assyrian king, more than it was an exact retelling of the history that's written on it. If you lived in the ancient city of Zinjali, you would see this monument right at the city's entry gates as you walked in. It was meant to strike fear in all who walked past of Assyria's total power. Let's take a quick walk all the way around the monument so you can see the whole thing.
I found there's tips and tricks to even doing something like cutting and folding paper. Make sure you've got a ruler, your template, you just need scissors and tape. And the first thing you want to do is when you cut, go ahead, and I started the cut line already, but cut on this side of the dark line and remove the top piece. When you've done that, get a nice fold by putting your ruler along that dotted line and fold, believe it or not, away from you. Give it a crease, remove the ruler, and you're done. Do the next one. Get it lined up, fold away from you, pull out the ruler, and really give it a good crease. I like to flip it around. And when you've done all of them, including that little tab, now you've got the lines in place to fold it the right way. There they are. Flip it over, and now give it a good crease. We included a little tab for you, and you simply put it all together, balance it on its side, and you can take a small piece of tape, line them up there on the edge. And just lock it in place. Do that one on the bottom, and you have completed your craft. Nicely done.
So if you like this craft, you can find more activities on our website on the HMSC Connects Kids and Families Activity page. This link is in the description below. Enjoy!